What is up, you guys? It is your boy Dominzs here at Common Sense Graphics, and y'all better hold on to your butts today because I'm about to freeze it in place with some hard facts. Today I'm going to be teaching you guys how to make a really cool old school retro neon rising sun, but let's jump right into the video. So the very first thing you're going to want to do is pull out your ellipse tool and make a giant circle, and then you want to center it with your alignment tools. And then right after that, you're going to want to hit the M button on your keyboard to make rectangles. And what you're going to want to do is you want to make them from super small to super big. So if you just watch me here, I'm going to start off making them very slender on the top portion. And then as I get lower with them, they become more and more wider. And it's real easy just to do this. Just takes no time at all. Just make them a little bit more wider. Make sure you hold down the Alt button when you're adjusting the size. And do not worry if the lines stretch out past the circle, because it's all part of the workflow. Makes things so much easier when you do it this way instead of doing it with a different tool. The blend tool, the path tool, is difficult. So what you do next is you're going to change the color of the image, as I did here, and then you're going to want to go to your Windows if you don't have it already on the side and open up your Pathfinder window. And so what I did here is I just selected everything and then I hit divide on everything, and then I got rid of the edges, and cleanup was just as easy as that. And now we can start messing with the colors. So for me, I had the colors I wanted to use personally picked out, but realistically, you can use a lot of colors for this as long as they're harmonizing with each other. And as you see here, I'm going to take all the black lines and I'm going to put a gradient onto them and just really have some fun with it. A gradient is highly recommended just because it adds a nice smooth color flow from one color to the next as it transitions. Usually the orange or yellow will be your peak of the sun, the part where, you know, the sun is already showing, you know, the rising sun, all that good stuff. And the bottom is usually always going to be like a pink or like a blue type of color that shows like the neon part of it. And then as we go on to the other part, the white part, I also add a gradient to this. It's the exact same gradient, but I do not drag the gradient as far down just to show it kind of like a ripple effect. And then what I do next is I add an opacity lowering to it. So I make it down to like maybe 30-40% low opacity just to show that. And then after that, what I do next, I select everything and then I go to path, offset path, and then I make the path offset, and then I change the background color to a darker color, or maybe it could be a lighter color depending on your own taste. And then I change it, then I arrange it and send it to the back. And that is pretty much it when it comes to making your own rising sun, just a quick rising sun with the cool fading effects to it. You can do a lot of things with it, with the color variation and different types of shapes you want to do. It don't always got to be a circle. You could do a lot of things from squares and things, and you can throw stuff into the mix by throwing things into the back. For example, what I did with this rising sun, I threw one of my more recent images, the image I made on Annie Monday, Haruko from flcl. I decided to throw her in the back, and I made her background color match the background color of the rising sun, so it gave it this really cool effect as if it was like, you know, just completely a part of it, and it looked really good. And I was like, wow, this is nice and it's really cool. You could do a lot of crazy things with this type of image, and you can have a lot of fun and just make it really pop out. Mine kind of it reminds me of a sticker, and I can't complain about it. If you guys are having any issues with this, this is a very, very easy entry-level tutorial for Adobe Illustrator. You can make a lot of cool things without too much effort and have it really shine. Usually I like to use colors with my images because colors really do show the vibrance of your image depending on how you want to make it. And with mine, I can literally make mine into like a sticker or something like that, and it'll just be like the coolest thing ever. If I want to sell it, probably sure it'll sell like hotcakes just because of how cool it is. And yeah, just have fun with it and just mix up with your own design and don't be afraid to experiment. But that's pretty much it. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Slap that like button. Hopefully I left you guys frozen in place with this small tutorial. But it's your boy Dominzs here at Common Sense Graphics. Slap that like button, subscribe, hit the bell icon, all that bullshit. Your boy out.